Hey everyone, today we're going to talk about iMovie editing. This is a tutorial, very basic things that you can do with editing if you're kind of a beginner and you don't want to spend a ton of time making a Hollywood style video. We just want to do basic editing to make our videos that we're putting on YouTube a little more interesting. So the first thing we're going to do is go into iMovie. We're going to import the video that we want, and I'm going to do this one right here. It was me in my home office just standing there talking to the camera. There was really very little going on except me talking. So I'm going to delete the whole audio for this so that you don't hear all the noise in the background. So I'm going to delete the very beginning part where I was getting myself ready, making sure that I looked presentable for the camera. I'm just going to delete all that part. And then as I start playing, I do a little intro. Hey everyone, welcome to my channel, and we are starting right now. Then I'm going to split the clip, and let's say that the next section, I want it to be more of a close-up. So I figure out where I want the close-up to start, where I want it to end, and I split that clip. And I'm assuming that you know the very basics of iMovie. You know how to split a clip. We select it, we go up here to that crop tool and say crop to fill. When you do that, you get these little grab handles to be able to resize the frame. So then back it up and press play and see how it looks. Now, I didn't zoom in enough. I think I want it to be a little bit more. So I'll go back into crop. I can zoom in a teeny bit more. I can drag the area around and then start back. Boom. So now I can see that I was able to zoom in a little bit. And then when I'm done, it'll zoom back out again. You have to remember when you're filming, you have to stand far enough away from the camera that you will be able to zoom in. If you're very close to the camera, when you zoom in, it's going to be an extreme close-up. So just keep that in mind as you're filming. Stand far enough away that you would be able to do that. Here we're doing it again. We're just going to grab the handles. Now this time, instead of centering it, I'm off center. And watch why I do that. So now that I'm off center, I have this empty space on the side where I could put in some graphics. What if I want to drop in my logo? I have this file over here called intros and outros. It's basically just an album that I've created in the iMovie library where I put in graphics and a little, you know, be sure to subscribe, that sort of thing. Things that I use over and over and over again. So let's say I want to drop my logo in here. I can just go find it in the album where I keep all of that stuff. And now, boom, because I'm off center, there's a place that I can put in a graphic. I could have text. I could do a picture in picture, anything like that. Let's talk about the Ken Burns effect. That is apparently some famous photographer where he has, you start out and you zoom in during the clip. So it's harder to describe, I'll just show you. So you hit play, you start out farther, and the thing just zooms in as the clip is playing. It's very subtle. You can even do it vice versa. So you started in tight and you zoomed out. But it's just something to make the video more interesting. So it's not just you standing there talking to the camera with one, and it's one big take with nothing really interesting for the viewer to look at. So let's see, what's another thing that I could do? We could do a transition. So here's something where I said, imagine this. And I look for a transition and I drop this one in there. So when I play it, it'll do this. Picture this, and then it does that little ripple effect. It's nothing crazy. It's just enough to give the viewer something to look at to keep their attention, because on YouTube, if they start to get bored, they're going to hit the back button. We want them to watch as much of the video as we possibly can. Now let's talk about how to change the speed of a clip. You're going to split it at the beginning and the end, highlight the one that you want to affect. Go up to this little thingy right here that is speed, and you can change it from normal to slow to fast. If you pick fast, you can say, is it twice as fast? Is it four times? Is it eight times? Is it 20 times as fast? I use this a lot when I'm doing a driving tour of a neighborhood, and I'm just holding my camera on the dashboard as I drive through the neighborhood. Then I'll speed it up so that later when I go back and watch it, it's, you know, it's 20 times as fast. We're seeing a little, you know, as we drive through the neighborhood, but it speeds it all up. And last but not least, this is how to drop in your intro and your outro. Again, have a folder with all of this stuff in it. All you have to do is highlight it, drag it down, drop it in, boom. So now at the very end of your video, your automated logo, your animated intro will play automatically. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this helpful, go ahead and give me a like and write a comment down below about something you learned today that you didn't know before. And consider subscribing to my channel. I teach real estate agents how to use YouTube to grow their businesses, because that's what I do. I get most of my business from my YouTube channel, and I'd love to share with you how I'm doing it so that you can do it in your market as well. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you on the next one.